What's up guys, it's Tommy here and welcome back to the FC24 Liverpool Career Mode Show, and we play Chelsea and a crucial, massively important Leipzig game in the Champions League. If we lose to Leipzig, we could actually go out in the group stages, so I'm really nervous but really excited for this episode as well. And as you can see, Man City have already beaten newly promoted Southampton 4-2, and we could put a real dent into Chelsea's title hopes if we beat them. And I'm bringing back the comment of the day section, where I thank you, one of you or two of you guys or three of you guys who left awesome, amazing comments on my previous videos. So comment of the day goes out to these guys that you can see below me on the screen. Thank you so much for your awesome support, and of course leave a like if you enjoy this these Liverpool Career Mode episodes. It really means the world to me, and you can support me further and you get more Career Mode content if you support me on Patreon. You can subscribe to different tiers where you get different benefits depending on how much money you pay for each tier. It only costs a few dollars per month, and it really helps me out, keeps me above water to keep continuing making these videos. I don't want to stop my Career Mode videos, so please subscribe to my Patreon, link in the video description. And Chelsea have a 20-year-old Spanish left back who is their captain, and he's already 82 rated, so probably he's either a youth academy player or they bought him for big money. And they have newly signed Martinez at right back, who is also a pretty brilliant player, and the Real Sociedad goalkeeper Ramiro. So they strengthened from Spain, which is an interesting transfer strategy. Inacio gets a big game because he's almost as good as Konate, and I want to try him out against Chelsea. But we are playing with two defensive midfielders just to shore up the defense a little bit. We conceded three goals in the previous game against Sporting.
Expectant Anfield for this one, and with good reason, as Liverpool prepare to take on Chelsea. Who is going to prevail?
Inacio. Salah. Oh my goodness, Salah is in. And Szoboszlai already with a brilliant chance. Oh, go on. Oh my goodness, Trent is bombing forward. And Trent can actually go in. And Gakpo! Twice! Come on, Salah. Mo Salah is in. And Salah! Yes! Mo Salah scores! The king of Egypt is our top scorer. This is a brilliant run by Salah, and nobody's picking him up in the box, and that's a big mistake by Chelsea. 10 goals in 12 matches. If Salah stays fit, we can come close to Erling Haaland's Premier League record. And Nkunku. Jackson! Oh, Marquinhos! Oh, that was a very, very important tackle. Yes, Nunez. Gakpo can run. Gakpo! Nunez! What a save, Ramiro! Salah. Gakpo! Wide open! Another save. I need cover. I need cover. Guys, Jackson. No! And that's a goal. Oh my goodness, what a big save by Alisson. I was robbed in the box of the ball, and that could have been a very undeserved equalizer. But now Chelsea have their best spell of the game. No. Oh, come on! Nkunku! No! I can't! I absolutely cannot get the ball off Chelsea! This is so unbelievably undeserved! I tried everything here! I have two players on Nkunku, and that's a mistake, because he passes the ball to a wide open Enzo Fernandez. Look at Chelsea! Oh my goodness! No. Ooh, Alisson. One of the most frustrating games of the season, because for 65 minutes we were all over Chelsea. We were creating chance after chance. We had almost 3 XG, 2.8 to their 1.5. And you can see the tail of the game. For 65 minutes we were all over them, and then Chelsea probably switched to a more aggressive tactic. And they just grinded us down and got a goal. Very, very annoying. And Ramiro saved a lot of our shots. So now Man City are 3 points clear of us. Arsenal lost though, which is a really good result for us because that puts Arsenal in a big distance. But yeah, Man United and Man City took advantage of us drawing. And Brighton beating Arsenal was a massive result for them. Leeds United, since they got promoted, built an amazing team. They have Facundo Farias, the big talent from Argentina, playing with Messi at Inter Milan. And also they signed Nico Williams from Athletic Bilbao and Solomon. And just to make the games even harder, I'm playing on 3-minute halves, and we have to rotate because we have the crucial Leipzig game just a few days after this one.
The tension is palpable, and you can understand why. Two high-level sides about to face each other, and it's anyone's guess how this is going to end up. United, they face Liverpool, taking on Liverpool.
Thanks, Derek. Yes, Endo.
This should be a good game. Great atmosphere inside the stadium. We've got two teams full of quality.
And Gakpo! Oh my goodness! That is one of the best goals of the season! Cody Gakpo with a stunning effort! And how come that the game is out for like 5 months and they still can't fix the scoreboard, that if a team plays in a white kit, you can't see their score in the on the scoreboard?
Who can he pick out? Under pressure, can he finish?
Oh, Kelleher, brilliant save! No, Solomon, great save, Kelleher. Oh, see you later. And Salah. Okay. Diaz. Ah, that's poor. Uh-oh, Nico Williams is lightning quick. And he will cut it back. And I told you, he will cut it back. And Kalimuendo, or whatever his name is, blasts it home. Tsimikas is injured, and so he couldn't chase down the player on the wing, and I have to substitute Tsimikas. And Kalimuendo, I was covering the far post with Van Dijk. Farias! 2-1 Leeds. Just not good enough. Just not good enough. Leeds United are running rings around our defense at the moment. And I knew that this was a very tough game, but I had to rotate anyway because the Leipzig game is just a few days after this one. Oh, go on, Bajčetić. And Jota, surely! Yes! Diogo Jota! Just came on as a substitute, that's his first contribution. And Darwin Nunez was so calm, he passed it to Jota and he buries it. Oh, Bajčetić, let's go. Soboslay. Go on, Soboslay. And Jota hits the bar, or the post, sorry. Endo. Soboslay. Jota, surely. Gakpo. Yes! Gakpo, 88th minute. We have done it. Unbelievable comeback. That is what makes champions champions. We never give up. We never lay down. This is Liverpool Football Club. We never say die. And we grinded it down, Leeds United. That is an amazing block. And we got lucky a little bit that it fell to Gakpo, who is one of our top scorers. And I think that's his second goal in this game. No, no way. 91st minute and Solomon goes past Bajčetić. No, Roca. Oh, great block, Inacio. What an epic comeback. And this is why I changed it to 3-minute halves, so we get more challenging games. We had very little time after Leeds went 2-1 up to change it around, but we did it anyway. And yes, it was indeed Cody Gakpo's second goal in this game. And I think we deserved it. We had a lot more shots, more possession, more XG. The second half was a thrilling, entertaining end-to-end game. And oh wow, Darwin Nunez gives an interview, but who was the man of the match? Kali Mwendo, okay. I have an amazing 15-year-old with great potential that I want to promote to the Youth Academy, but we need to release first someone because the Youth Academy is full. So I will promote this guy, not release, but promote. I will promote this guy and probably put him on the transfer list just so he can grow his potential. He is not an amazing player, Henry Bond, but I love his name. My name is Bond, Henry Bond. Thankfully, Tsimikas is only out for 5 days. Man City keep on winning. Now they have an even better goal difference than us because they beat Leicester 3-0, so it was crucial that we beat Leeds United, Man United, Tottenham, Newcastle, Arsenal won. The big losers of the round are Chelsea with only a draw. And the fight against relegation is fascinating, only Southampton are cut adrift at the moment. And McAllister is back from his injury, so he will be on the bench against Leipzig. And the next game is must win. We have to beat Leipzig and then we can still maybe finish in top spot. But if we beat Leipzig, we have a good chance of qualifying because I think we will beat Shakhtar in the last round. Leipzig have an amazing team and they beat us 3-1 at home at Anfield. So I want to take revenge. And we played actually better than them, which they were just clinical. So we have to defend better and we need to be more clinical with our chances than in the first game. And we are playing in the snow, which will be making the game even harder, even more interesting.
What a game we have in store for you today. The hype has been building all week and we're just moments from kickoff.
Lukaku. Close him down, Alisson. Salah. And Darwin Nunez! Oh, he can't chip Gulacsi from there.
Gakpo.
Nunez! No! He misses it! Gakpo.
Ibrahim Songare. And Liverpool might be able to cash in.
Nunez.
Gakpo. Here's Salah.
Soboslay. To Trent Alexander-Arnold, he scores! Trent Alexander-Arnold, the Scouser! He's our captain today because Van Dijk is not playing. That's his first goal and it was all about the team play move. And look at Trent bombing forward. I always say him to join the attack and to bomb forward and play as an inverted right back. And in the snow, with the yellow ball, he finishes it.
What can they do from here?
No. Lukaku!
Huge block.
Brilliant.
Alexander Arnold. On to Konate.
Oh, nice.
Soboslay.
Oh, we are out of the press.
Alexander Arnold.
Endo. What have you done, Endo? Oyarzabal. No! Saivald, great block, Konate.
Counter-attacking ability to good effect.
Oh boy, Endo. Endo, what a tackle, Endo. I didn't see that guy coming. And Lukaku. Openda. Come on. Close him down. McAllister. Robertson. Diaz. And Jota! How did the defender get there? Yes! We've done it! Oh my goodness, what a massive win in the Champions League! And now it's still in our hands. To qualify to the knockout stages, it was an even game. So to win it and to keep a clean sheet is actually brilliant. But Leipzig blocked so many of my shots. or we just couldn't hit the target. And Konate was the man of the match, but shout out to Alisson as well, who made some big, big saves. And this Leipzig team are world class. And now, if we beat Shakhtar Donetsk, we are 100% through to the next round, because our head-to-head result to Sporting is better. I think Leipzig already won the group, that's pretty evident. But maybe they could even get knocked out. If Sporting beat Leipzig by 2 goals, then their head-to-head record will be better than Leipzig. Rangers are through to the knockout stages, which is absolutely crazy. And PSV are probably through to the Europa League. Dortmund, who were one of the favorites, are out, which is really surprising. PSG and Newcastle are already through. In this one, we all want to avoid PSG, of course, but we will probably finish in second place. I will try my best to beat Shakhtar, and then we will see what happens. Man City and Benfica are pretty much through, but maybe Atletico have an outside chance if they beat Benfica away from home. Barcelona are out! What is going on? Some of the really big teams are out of the Champions League. My girlfriend is a Barcelona fan and she is not happy looking at me. This is just a game, don't worry about it. Sorry, she is my wife, not my girlfriend. Oh my goodness, I'm even bigger trouble than I thought I am. Real Madrid and Leverkusen are also through. AC Milan and Man United can be worried, but yeah, probably Man United should go through. And wow, Inter and Monaco will go head to head to determine who goes through. It's incredible that Aston Villa built an Atletico Madrid strike force with Depay and Griezmann alongside each other. So I expect a super tough game, and I have to rotate, and also I have to bring in Jota and McAllister, who badly need a start after their long injury layoffs. And he still goes in! And Kamara makes it 1-0, because Moussa Diaby just completely bamboozled me. That really close dribbling was amazing, and Robertson just couldn't block Kamara's shot. Diaby, again, he's bamboozling me. Depay. Alisson almost gave away a penalty there. McAllister. Salah, Jota, surely! No! He hits the bar! McAllister. And Salah, bugged again. Go on. Salah. Jota, McAllister, yes! Brilliant goal! Alexis McAllister comes back with a goal! Fantastic passing move, Salah to Jota, and look at how unselfish Jota is. And McAllister finishes it off. Sangare. And Gakpo! No, I should have shot first time.
Excellent assessment of the situation at the back.
Endo.
Liverpool try to click into an attacking gear with the game level.
Gakpo, surely! Yes! Cody Gakpo! 84th minute! He again could win us a crucial game very late, just like against Leeds United. Cody Gakpo is in the form of his life, and he is delivering and scoring in almost every game. What a huge comeback! Once again, we come from behind to beat Aston Villa, and they are a solid side. And we absolutely need to keep winning, because Man City are probably doing the same. And Aston Villa scored one goal from 0.3 XG, so we thoroughly deserve this win. First half, Aston Villa were better. Second half, we were the better team. And McAllister was the man of the match. He came back from injury with a goal. And this Aston Villa team has a chance to qualify for the European places, because they have built an amazing side, just like in real life, to be fair. Man City are putting up results just like they do in real life. They are pretty much almost like invincible so far. Yeah, they are unbeaten. Yeah, the only unbeaten side. Arsenal played out a 3-0 draw against Newcastle. Chelsea drew, Tottenham lost. but Man City won. And also Man United dropped points. So the Man City and Liverpool have pulled away, which I think is good. And I expect Man City to go toe-to-toe with us for the title. Brighton and Brentford are in the relegation zone, but it's very tight at the bottom, as you can see. And Almiron is the top scorer. Amazing season, 13 goals in 15 games. Salah has 10 goals. Gakpo has 8 goals now. So Gakpo is now scoring more than Darwin Nunez, which is amazing. But Nunez has 6 assists. He's also having a great season. Salah has 4 assists as well. And Alisson kept 3 clean sheets already, which is nice. Even though Salah's rating keeps going down, he's still our best player, our top scorer. 12 goals and 5 assists. Amazing season he's having. And Cody Gakpo really rose up this season after an injury plagued last season. Darwin Nunez, brilliant as ever. And Luis Diaz as well. So our 4 main attackers are brilliant. Jota, of course, was hit with a 3-month injury. So he's just gaining his match sharpness and hopefully he will score a lot more goals. Szoboszlai is having a pretty quiet season so far, but I think he will start banging in the goals very, very soon. And yeah, a lot of our goals are shared around. And as you can see, we have an amazing array of young talent who are improving all the time, and I'm really looking forward to developing him and developing them and growing them. And some of them are even playing for, you know, Premier League sides like Tyler Morton, Kumatio, Kish, Shimon, Kish, the other Kish as well. So that's really nice. Conor Bradley as well for Crystal Palace. The next episode is going to be a really important one. We need to keep our winning run going. We need to win every game until we play Arsenal, and then we need to keep winning as well in those big games coming up. And I'm really looking forward to it. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this. Have a nice day. See you later.
Goodbye.